say, can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched, were so gallantly streaming, and the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the home of the brave?
Quisqueyanos valientes, alcemos nuestro canto con viva emoción, y del mundo a la faz ostentemos nuestro invicto glorioso pendón. Salve el pueblo que intrépido y fuerte a la guerra a morir se lanzó, cuando en bélico reto de muerte sus cadenas de esclavo rompió. Ningún pueblo ser libre merece si es esclavo indolente y servil, si en su pecho la llama no crece, que tembló el heroísmo viril. Mas Quisqueya, la inóbita y brava, siempre activa la frente alzará, que si fuese mil veces esclava, otra tanta se libre sabrán. ¡Viva República Dominicana! ¡Viva la República Dominicana!
¡Viva! 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 I'm going to let to acknowledge the latest officials attending this event today. We have a Secretary County, Deputy Secretary County, Mike Hovland, D8, Dominica Valley 4, Don Wars. We have from the State Senator, James Kufis. We have Mike Anagostis, Assemblyman Ken Zembrowski, Jehu Sen Excuse. We have Rockland County, County Clerk. She said that she's Dominican now because she's visited a couple times Punta Cana. Doma Governor Silverman. And also Sabrina Greco, Confidential Assistant to the Chairman of the Rockland County Legislature. We have he will know in my town, in Tamboril, more than me right now, Supervisor Howard Phillips. We have the councilman that is in the excuse, Isidro Papo Cancel, John Gould, and Vince Camboli. We have Alex Guarinos. Now he's Dominican too. Assistant, Supervisor Assistant. We have Raquel Ventura, County Clerk. Town Clerk. Thank you, Mike. Rosa Urina, Constituent Representative. And also we have from West Aviso, Mayor Robert D'Amelio, Trustee Ralph Kisker, Ramon Lopez, Francis Nari, Balagro. We have Richard Pacola. This is the judge from West Aviso. From the Village, we have Michael Cohart, Mayor, Trustee Joel Santana, and Gio Calavero. And also, Ron DiCaprio is here for the job from the Village of Harveston.
Trustee Ralph Bueno is in the Dominican Republic.
Rafael Bueno is enjoying the good weather in the Dominican Republic.
Goes
Rosalind Serrano. Rosalind Serrano also is here. Community leaders, we have Sahira Rodriguez, Joseph Silverio, Carmen Tavares. Also, we have a good friend of Quisqueya Sport Club, Serafin Wu. He's all over the place supporting the community. And we have...
Thank you for all for coming out today. We ordered good weather and it came, so we're happy for that. We've all been here when it's been much worse than this, so we're very thankful. And we're proud. How many years now are we doing this, Johnny?
178.
How many?
The independent, 178.
No. That we've been doing this. Yeah? Whatever it is, we're happy to host this because it's significant for a big portion of our community that they know that they are respected and honored here in Havistraw. No matter what your nationality is, we're a village made up of many nationalities, and we're willing and happy to honor all of those nationalities. I just wish your anniversary date was in like June or something. It'd be much nicer, but we'll take what we get. But we're thankful that we're happy to have everybody here, and I hope everybody enjoys themselves and has a good Independence Day. Thank you.
Gracias a Michael Gunning. ¿Va a decir algo? Okay. Miren, también a Porfirio Martínez, que está grabando para la historia, quien es nuestro canchanchan compañero. También está Edo Rosario para la Voz del Pueblo, que constituye una de las páginas en Facebook más vista porque toca temas durísimos. Es el momento también de darle espacio a quien organice el evento. 1844, fecha importantísima para nuestro país, 187 años, una época, un tiempo que tiende a recomenzar, cada año tendremos que recomenzar porque vienen retos nuevos en materia personal, en materia social, en materia económica, pero lo bueno es que el dominicano tiene una coraza de acero. No importa el tiempo que venga, siempre está ahí. Por eso llamamos al organizador del evento, que es el presidente del Quisqueya Sport Club, don Roberto Germosén.
Ok, buenas tardes. La directiva, por favor. Joseph Silverio, Alex, Fernando Peña. Hoy damos gracias por estar aquí todos presentes, celebrando el 178 aniversario de lo que es nuestra independencia dominicana. Hoy podemos decir que somos libres e independientes de esos vecinos la cual nos arroparon por tanto tiempo. Y ya tenemos 178 aniversario con ese grito de patria, libre y libertad. El Quisqueya Sport Club se siente más que agradecido de tener siempre este apoyo de los americanos. Sabemos que estamos en un país, como dicen, ajeno al nuestro, pero de verdad, el calor que nos brindan ustedes, con ese recibimiento que nos dan al momento de nosotros alzar nuestra bandera un día como hoy. Mil bendiciones para todos de parte del Quisqueya Sport Club.
A nosotros en todos los eventos. Por eso llamamos al asambleísta, vamos a decir histórico, Ken Zembrowski, que también tiene palabras para este evento. Así es que, welcome Ken Zembrowski. Aplauso que fuerte, que se siente en la plaza para Zembrowski, ¿ok?
So I come here every year. Many times I'm running back from Albany to join you on Dominican Independence Day. Today was a nice Sunday, so we figured we'd all come. So my wife Claire is here, and my daughter Reagan, and my son Kenny. We're happy to celebrate. And, you know, as the mayor said, it's important for us all to gather together and here in the village of Havistraw, across the county of Rockland, and across the state of New York to celebrate our diverse cultures, and also celebrate how we come together as one. We come together in small communities like this and across our state. Later this week, we'll be passing a resolution celebrating Dominican Independence Day up in the state legislature. It struck me today as coming down here, though, that also, you know, while we watch on TV a conflict across the globe where Ukraine is attempting to retain its independence, that we recognize that we should all stand together for the rights of people to maintain their sovereignty, for self-determination, and for the respect of every country. So today's about a celebration, but, and we all celebrate our diversity and how we've all come together here in Rockland County, but it should also be a remembrance of what can happen when people are not, don't respect self-determination and the rest of people to have their sovereignty and not have their borders breached. So thanks so much for all, always including me in this celebration. And lastly, Viva la República Dominicana.
Thank you. Buenas tardes, amigos. ¿Cómo está? Well, thank you for having me out on to celebrate Independence Day of the Dominican Republic. As our assemblymen just say, the Dominicans, when they won their independence from Haiti, the United States, from England, and now we see a fight with Ukraine against Russia. We all can stand united as peoples that understand the importance of independence and the necessity of fighting for freedom every day of our lives. So Dominicans, Americans, thank you for your support for democracy. And also I wanted today, I'm very fortunate that I have a plaque for a Dominican American who understands the importance of working for our community. I look around us today and I see that basically we have gone maskless, except for a few in the back, which they're certainly entitled to wear. But as we look back over the last couple of years, we understand that the stress that the village of Haverstraw and all of its people in the county of Rockland and of this great nation have gone through struggling with the pandemic, trying to work, trying to stay healthy. And today, help me, I'd like to call up Vanessa Martinez. She's here, right? Yeah, if you step up. And I'm here to give her a plaque from our district attorney's office, because here is a Dominican American woman who struggled during the pandemic to ensure that the people of Haverstraw, Rockland County, and particularly our Latino population received a vaccination. I hate to look back at that time when many people were frightened and concerned about getting a vaccine. They wanted to stay healthy. And Ms. Martinez never stopped that fight. She worked tirelessly on behalf of everyone to ensure that they were vaccinated, that the clinic was open, and it served the people of the village of Haverstraw. So can I ask everyone, please give it up for Ms. Martinez, Vanessa Martinez. A proud example of the courage of a Dominican American woman who fights for her community. Ms. Martinez, thank you. On behalf of the Rockland County District Attorney's Office, we're giving you our Community Service Award, presented to Vanessa Martinez with great honor and recognition for your loyal and dedicated service to the citizens of Rockland County during the COVID-19 pandemic. Now, I know on the bottom it says May 21, but you got so busy, we couldn't get around to giving it to you until Independence Day. So thank you. Thank you. Would you like to say a few words?
Okay. I want to thank everyone for coming here today. It is an honor to be Dominican and to represent my the community that I grew up in, and to serve all the Latinos here. Thank you so much. It means a lot to me.
To me every year. Congratulations. Happy Independence Day. I love being in the village of Haverstraw. Everybody here is so warm and welcoming, and it's always a pleasure to come. Thank you.
I don't know why Michael is looking at you like this. I got that. We're talking about diversity, we're talking about inclusion also, sir. I know Ken Zembrowski mentioned about that we are celebrating the diversity also, as well. But we have one person that he's always make sure that we have the He knows that we have diversity, but he always focuses about that we have equity and inclusion also, sir. It's a person that he always focuses about what the community needs. So especially for the Latino community, so he's always looking for to see how we can do. Anytime that I call him up to ask for something that we need, he told me right away, what do you need, Johnny, for that community or for the person that we need that support? So I would like to bring here to the podium now, like Martin mentioned about that, he's from Tamboril too. Let me bring over here Supervisor Howard Phillips.
That's very kind of you. Well, first of all, that's very, very kind of our councilman, Johnny Ortiz. As a matter of fact, the first Dominican-American councilman in the history of the town of Havistraw. I want to touch on a little bit more and embellish upon what our Assemblyman Ken Zabrowski was talking about. Here in America, we're a group of people from all different backgrounds, nationalities, creeds, and beliefs. But we're all one people from the many one. Just as we threw off back in 1776, the chains of tyranny, so did the people of the Dominican Republic, which we celebrate today. But in Europe right now, the Ukrainian people, just like you and I, once again are going to try and throw off the chains of tyranny because of a madman thinks he should control the lives of others. Haven't we had enough of that in the world? Enough of killing and destruction. We need to come together. And I ask you today, on this beautiful day that we get to celebrate the independence of the wonderful people from Dominican Republic, tonight, before you go to bed, before you lay your head down on your pillow, say a prayer. Say a prayer to our Lord to ask for his guidance and intervenience. And if you do the rosary, ask our lovely lady to intercede, to ask her son to help those people. Because we are one people. No matter what we look like, no matter who we come from, we are all one people. So today, we get to celebrate a wonderful culture, a wonderful people. Congratulations, and thank you so much.
Thank you. Johnny va a traducir. Aplausos fuertes para Michael, Howard, y nos toca ahora alguien importantísimo, señores. Una persona que ha estado apoyando todas las actividades deportivas y le ha dicho a la gente que organiza eventos aquí que su villa, siempre y cuando sea para favorecer la comunidad, está disponible, puede aportar. Recibamos con un fuerte aplauso a un tipo sano, bueno, Robert de Amelio, mayor de West Havistraw.
Thank you, Ramon. As everybody's mentioned, what a beautiful day it is. We've had some pretty cold, long two-hour days here. Carmen, I saw a picture of you today on Facebook, so I put my red, white, and blue on to support you and the beautiful young... How about the beautiful young ladies here? So I want to thank, first I want to thank Mayor Kohut and his board. I see Joel here, Gil here, for hosting this event every year. Thank you so much. It means so much, not just to the village of Havistraw, but everybody says, supervisor said, it's a town, the whole town event. And Johnny went through the numbers of, you know, what the population of the Latinos and Dominicans are. And we so much are happy and proud to be a part. And you let us welcome us into your community all the time. I also want to thank all the members behind me and all the members of the Casella Sports Club for all that you do. I know we just celebrated a young lady who did so much also back here for getting people vaccinated. Thank you so much. But I know also the Casella Sports Club for the during the pandemic. It was every day. It was every weekend. It was every Friday night. It was every holiday. And it's not much than what they do also all the time. But during the pandemic,
You know, you guys really stepped it up. The ladies stepped it up. We're now losing a lot of these volunteer groups and these organizations. They don't exist anymore. And we're so happy to have the Kaseya Sports Club step up and take on the role of doing so much for the community. So thank you so much.
Our feel is mandándole un mensaje a la comunidad que somos bien diversificados aquí y siempre él está apoyando y menciona también lo que es lo que está pasando en Ucrania y que nosotros aquí somos una comunidad que siempre estamos juntos y no importa dónde tú vengas. Y lo mismo Robert de Amelio que manda un mensaje y le da la gracia también a todos los organizadores. I would like to bring to the podium right now Deputy Secretary of County, Mark Hoblin, that he can say a few words also, sir.
Thank you, everybody, and congratulations on this very special day. I'm representing County Executive Ed Day. I was recently nominated as his deputy just a few days ago. Just in keeping from what everybody was already saying earlier, the speakers, liberty and freedom is what binds us all as Americans. And what our strength is in our diversity. And also one other thing is that I think is very important of us to know, our traditions are what also make us a nation. So I love to see the kids here celebrating that tradition and learning about freedom and what that all means. Congratulations. Thank you.
I would like to call here Mike Anakoske. He cannot be here, you know, also, sir, because Jens Kofi couldn't be here. He's going to have a few words also, sir.
Thank you, Councilman. Thank you. Thank you, everyone. My name is Mike Anagnostakis. I'm actually an Orange County legislator, but I'm senior advisor to Senator James Skoufis, and I'm here representing him today. Unfortunately, he couldn't make it here today, but I could tell you my sentiments are his sentiments. And I try to wear the right colors today. Because, as everyone said, I think we're all Dominican today, every single one of us. And others have mentioned it, but I think the thing that every human being treasures more than anything else is independence and freedom. And we see that playing out with current events happening all over the world. So I hope we all take a moment and pray that the spirit of the Dominican independence movement makes its way all over the world. As I said, the senator couldn't be here, but he has for seven individuals that have helped the community tremendously. If I can give this to the councilman, actually, and he could probably hand it out to them later on. The senator is proud to present them with their certificate of recognition from the New York State Senate, signed by him, Senator James Skoufis. Congratulations, everyone. Congratulations on independence.
Y sean cada vez mejor seres humanos. No podemos dar espacio a que lo malo brille. Tenemos también que ser mejores personas. Cuando usted es una mejor persona, hasta usted duerme mejor. Cuando usted se encarga de hacer el bien, eso es como la semilla buena, crece. No importa, crece. Porque al final la gente dice, fulano, fulana hizo algo bueno. Y debemos hacer lo bueno. Tengamos el espacio para hacer lo mejor que podamos hacer. Vamos a reconocer, aquí se unifican varios renglones. Michael Cujat por la Villa de Javestro, el que es por Claude, el Town y Rockland van a reconocer, van a entregar pergaminos a los que vamos a llamar para que reciban un homenaje en este importante día que es el de la independencia de la República Dominicana. Estudiantes meritoria, personas que han descollado en el mundo de la enseñanza. También han sido pastores importantes orientando a las ovejas en materia religiosa y así por el estilo. Llamamos a, en primera plana, para que reciba sus reconocimientos a Rocibel Ventura, quien tendrá su cargo recibir. Roberto, ¿dónde está tu placa, Roberto? Llamamos a Joel Santana para que también junto a Roberto se encargue de entregar el primer reconocimiento a esta joven que proviene de Tamboril, pero que nació aquí. Okay, se crió allá. Rocibel Ventura, que es de los famosos. Robert, profe, ella de Geno Ventura, creo que bisnieta. Okay. Así es que un aplauso para esta dama que está descollando en materia educativa y que nos representa de manera digna. Roberto, Joel y los demás autoridades que van a entregar el pergamino, ¿ok?
Ok. Es decir que tú eres de los de Alcide Ventura, de Tamboril.
Sí.
Oh, excelente profesor y director de allá del Liceo Nocturno Tamboril. Joel, acércate por aquí, por favor, para que haga entrega a nombre de Quisqueya por Club. Vamos a darle lectura.
Ventura, porque eres una joven valiosa, destacada profesional del derecho, quien con su actitud de trabajo en favor a los suyos eleva nuestro nivel de desarrollo comunitario. Gracias, interesante mujer, por tu aporte, Dios y nuestra comunidad. Te bendicen grandemente. Dado en la villa de Javestro, el día de hoy, el día de la independencia.
We are so lucky that we have two people also swear this year from the Dominican Republic also swear. So at this time, we're going to call the town de Javestro from Supervisor Howard Phillips also to hand out the certificate to Roosevelt.
Roosevelt, congratulations on behalf of the people of the town of Havistra, and we'd like to present this. I'm going to ask our town clerk, Raquel Ventura, to come on up here and read this. Raquel is the first Dominican-American town clerk in the history of Havistra. Raquel, would you please?
Absolutely. Este es un certificado de servicio distinguido de parte del pueblo de Havistra para Rosibel Ventura. Y no, no somos familia. We are Venturas. dándote mucha felicitación y apreciación por tu servicio que has rendido a las personas del pueblo de Havistra, Nueva York, en este día, febrero 27 de 2022. Muchas felicidades. Okay.
Thank you. Congratulations.
Look over here for us.
Wait.
Raquel,
get back here.
Can you just
step
up?
Can
we get you in front, Roosevelt?
Yeah.
Thank you. 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 Roosevelt Ventura also is the assistant, the DH in Rockland County, also for Stonewalls. This is the time now that we're going to be called here. Mike, also as well from Senator James Coffes.
Thank you again. Roosevelt, it's my honor. Did I say that right or wrong?
Yeah, right.
It's my honor to present to you from the New York State Senate and from Senator James Scoofus a certificate of recognition to you, Roosevelt Ventura, commemorating your outstanding contribution to the Dominican community. This date, February 27, 2022, signed by Senator James Scoofus. Congratulations. Congratulations. Smile. All right, congratulations. Thank you for all your great work.
Thank you.
Now this is the time to bring here Ken Sembroski, also as assemblyman.
Thank you, and I hope you have a lot of wall space because we're all extending great accolades to you. So also, like my good colleague James Scoofus in the State Senate, the other house, the State Assembly, would like to present you with this Certificate of Merit. And congratulations, and thanks so much for all you do.
Now this is the time that I'm going to bring also Mike from Executive Ed Day, also, sir.
Only a few more.
So Rockland County Executive Honorable Edwin J. Day presents this award of recognition to Roosevelt Ventura. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Viva la República Dominicana. Viva. Adiós.
Thank you.
And I'm gonna leave my at the end. Now I'm gonna bring over here Robert D'Amelio from West Amazon.
So, like as everybody said, I hope you have plenty of wall space. Thank you for all that you've done. For certificate of recognition, I'm going to have Arderis Ortiz read it out in Dominican.
En honor de todo lo positivo que tú has hecho para la comunidad bien diversa que tenemos aquí en la villa de West Havishaw y en la villa de Hamilton, te aplaudimos por todo lo que haces en parte de toda la gente de North Rockland.
Gracias.
We're not done yet, all right? Now this is the time that I'm going to bring here my cohort from the Village of Harbison.
Well, Roosevelt, I wanted to congratulate you as well. I'm not going to read the certificate. I think everybody has the general gist, but all the best and much appreciation for all that you've done for the community, and we wish you well. Thank you.
Thank you, Mike. Now we're gonna bring the last one. So Sabrina Greco is gonna be here for the County Legislature.
Gracias. Okay, primera cosa, I wanna let everybody know that I'm so proud and honored to be here and to have raised the flag. So proud to be Dominican. Mi gente, es un placer estar aquí con ustedes, es un orgullo ser dominicana y celebrar la independencia dominicana hoy, representando a nuestros padres y nuestros hijos. Y estoy tan orgullosa de estar en esta villa que aquí crecí yo y representando el presidente de la legislatura, Jay Hood, que no es dominicano, pero nació aquí en Havistro y aquí fue que fue a la escuela, en la escuela San Pedro, y aquí siempre está su corazón y representándonos en la legislatura, pero también en la villa como abogado. So, es un placer estar y reconocer a todos los que están recibiendo reconocimiento hoy, comenzando con la señorita Ventura. Felicidades, esto es una así mismo. Ok, yo nací aquí, solo español no está perfecto, pero estaba muy orgullosa de ti y todo el trabajo que tú estás haciendo. So, felicidades.
Muchas gracias. Gracias. Le faltó decir que somos dominicanos hasta la tambora. Martín, so we're going to go. I know that Tom Walsh, he would like to say a few words, sir.
Thank you, Johnny, and I'm very happy to tell you, what is it, about two and a half years ago, I had the first opportunity to meet Roosevelt. And I was so impressed by the third-year law student from the University of Buffalo Law School that I had no choice. I hired her. So I'm very proud to tell you that Roosevelt Ventura is an assistant district attorney of Rockland County, serving the Dominican Americans of Rockland and all Rocklanders. What a great young woman. So Dominicans, mom, dad, thank you very much. Now I have one more thing, so I don't want Roosevelt to get too mad about me, but let's give her a big round of applause. It was her birthday yesterday. Feliz cumpleaños, Roosevelt. Thank you, Johnny.
Thank you, Tom. So, Roosevelt,
Muchas felicidades a todos los dominicanos. Propicio es agradecer el servicio de Roosevelt Ventura, la primera Assistant District Attorney del condado. De parte de todos los dominicanos aquí en el condado de Rockland, le queremos entregar esta chaqueta, ya que para que siempre lleve el escudo de la bandera en su corazón, Dios, patria y libertad.
Roosevelt, now this is your time, Roosevelt, to say a few words.
Muy buenas tardes a todo el mundo.
Primero le quiero dar gracias a Dios por ser mi guía en todo momento de mi vida. También le quiero dar muchas gracias a la comunidad dominicana de Javestro por tomarme en cuenta para ser reconocida. También gracias a mi familia que me han apoyado, mi mamá, mi papá, mi hermana, que me han apoyado en todo momento, me han querido, me han amado y me han echado para adelante. También le quiero dar muchas gracias al District Attorney Tom Walsh y a todo su personal por creer en mí, darme la oportunidad y depositar confianza en mí para yo poder servir a mi comunidad. Muchas gracias a todos mis amigos también, que también me han ayudado. Yo quiero tomar este momento para decirle a los jóvenes hispanos, especialmente a los dominicanos de Javestro y de Rockland entero, que estudien, que salgan adelante, que tengan una carrera, que no hay nada que nos pare a nosotros en este país. Yo no nací aquí, yo nací en la República Dominicana. Yo llegué aquí, yo aprendí inglés a los 11 años y no dejé que nada me parara. Y llegué hasta donde estoy ahora. Me siento muy orgullosa de ser dominicana. Gracias. Así que siempre voy a tener mi país, siempre voy a representar a mi país enfrente. Y al final también quiero dedicar todo este reconocimiento a mi abuela, mi abuelita Herminia Esteves, que tristemente falleció al principio de este mes. Y ella me ayudó mucho, pero yo sé que ella está allá arriba mirando para abajo y con mucha emoción, ¿verdad? Pero muchas gracias. Now I want to say a little bit in English. Thank you, everyone, for thank you, the town. Thank you, all the elected officials, for recognizing me. I'm really honored to be here. I'm really honored to serve my community. I'm honored that I'm able to do this and put my flag in the front every time I go to court or every time I'm doing whatever I'm doing with my job. It's an honor for me to be here. I also want to thank the district attorney again. I said it in Spanish, I'm saying it in English now, for giving me the opportunity and for believing that at such a young age and right after law school, I could do my job and I will continue to do my job. So thank you, everyone. I'm really honored. I'm really excited, that's why I sound so shaky. So I hope everyone has a good day and happy Independence Day. Feliz Día de la Independencia Dominicana.
Aplauso fuerte para la señorita Ventura, ¿eh? Merecidísimo los reconocimientos en este momento. Hay que le corresponde ser reconocido en este momento. Yo estoy entre los que me siento orgulloso, contento, porque él ha crecido en materia educativa. La edad, el tiempo, la capacidad económica, la ha aprovechado en todos los renglones para cultivar la educación y prepararse. Y hoy pienso que este reconocimiento que se le hace a este joven, que ya tiene descendencia doble, es súper merecido. Cuando hablamos de una persona que proviene de la humildad y ha estado en todos los estamentos creciendo, formándose, tratando de ser cada vez mejor persona y mejor profesional, vale la pena reconocerlo. Y por eso, en este día importante para los dominicanos, nosotros llamamos con orgullo, contento, satisfecho, a un joven que se merece ese reconocimiento, estos reconocimientos en el día de hoy. Con un fuerte aplauso, llamamos al amigo, al hermano, al doctor, al licenciado Carlos José Rosario, quien va a ser reconocido en el día de hoy. Un tamborileño progresista que ha crecido. Así que venga con la familia, Carlos. Que venga la familia, que la familia no puede quedarse. Así es que, Johnny.
Now this is the time that we're going to honor Carlos José Rosario. We're going to start with Quisqueya Sport Club.
Este reconocimiento a nombre de Quisqueya Sport Club en la villa de Javestro dice: Quisqueya Sport Club, institución social, cultural, de servicio. Okay. Licenciado Carlos José Rosario, noble y altruista tamborileño, orgulloso, nuestro profesional de alto nivel, maestro educador por excelencia que enseña con el ejemplo y contribuye desde siempre grandemente con el desarrollo social de nuestro tamboril y nuestras instituciones. Gracias por ser como eres. Dios te colme de bendiciones junto a lo tuyo y la vida en abundancia para que siga haciendo el bien. Dado en la Villa de Javestro, 27 de febrero del año 22.
So before we continue for this, I would like to mention a good remark for Carlos José Rosario. So Carlos José Rosario is from the Dominican Republic. He's a college professor in the Dominican Republic. Accounting, CPA, lawyer, MBA, doctor in public administration also as well. And professional speaker. Also, he oversees the government office about ethics and transparency in the Dominican Republic. I'm going to continue now with the honorable. I'm going to call Howard Phillips.
Thank you, Johnny. Clearly, Carlos, you've had an extraordinary career, and really, you've done so much work. We're really proud to present this with to you today. I'm going to ask my constituent representative, Rosa Urena, to come on up here. Rosa, as Johnny likes to remind me all the time, was born in Tamboril. So, one of your own residents here to present this to you.
Buenas tardes. Como dominicana, específicamente tamborileña, es un honor y un placer poder otorgarle este reconocimiento por su contribución enormemente que ha hecho a la comunidad dominicana, especialmente tamboril. Muchas gracias por estar aquí, por su presencia, que Dios lo bendiga.
Congratulations. Congratulations. Take a photo. Thank you, guys. Thank you. Congratulations.
Thank you. They told me that it's getting cold over here. Let's do this right now. I'm gonna bring over here. You know, the rest of the people that we need to handle the certificate over here. I'm going to call Mike to come over here. Ken Sembroski also, sir. And then we can do Mike. You can come over. Robert D'Amelio also, sir. Come over here with a certificate for Carlos José Rosario. So we can do that.
Congratulations on behalf of Rockland County Executive Ed Day, the award of recognition presented to Carlos José Rosario. Congratulations.
Thank you. Now I'm going to continue with Mike Cohat.
Carlos, again, all the best. Obviously, you're an accomplished man, and you're a real symbol for the folks who are Dominican Republic ancestry. To be proud of. So I wanted to congratulate you and present you with this certificate.
Robert D'Amelio.
Carlos, congratulations. I don't know where you find the time. Have you found the time to do everything you've done? No, you have a lot. Yes.
Yeah.
Okay. But wow, very impressive. Thank you so much on behalf of the Village of West Havistor. And Darius, if you would just read.
Eso es un honor de su dedicación a su país y a la gente de su país y por todo lo que usted hace y por todo lo positivo especialmente que usted hace.
When I call up Ken Sembroski.
All right. Carlos, also congratulations on behalf of the New York State Assembly and the State of New York.
So... The last one from Sabrina.
Señor, una gran felicidad para usted, para nosotros, que usted aquí con nosotros. Lo felicitamos hoy. Y este es un certificado del condado de Jorge.
Muchas gracias.
Carlos José, take the floor. If you work for you.
Muy buenas tardes a todos. La verdad es que hoy es un día muy especial para mí, para mi familia. Aquí está mi hija Yudicar. Aquí está mi hermana Jocelyn. Hace ya 25 años que vine a este pueblo. Como un visitante caminé por estas calles. Aquí sentí un calor fuerte en el verano y el frío intenso del invierno. Y cuando traje a mi hija en aquel tiempo, ella entendió que este era el mejor lugar para ella vivir y para hacer su familia. Y la verdad es que nosotros, los de Tamboril, estamos extremadamente orgullosos de venir a este lugar. Y además, no hay manera de poder medir el agradecimiento que tenemos los tamborileños con todos aquellos que son nativos de este lugar, que son autoridades y que piensan en nosotros como sus hermanos, como sus amigos. Cada vez que venimos aquí sentimos la alegría de la familia. Y cuando ustedes van allí, naturalmente el pueblo se volca a la calle para abrazarlos, porque es la misma sangre. Somos seres humanos y somos hermanos, todos hijos de Dios. Así que hoy, en el Día de la Independencia Nacional Dominicana, estoy extremadamente feliz y le agradezco a todas las instituciones esta iniciativa de tomar en consideración el esfuerzo que hemos hecho durante toda la vida. Ojalá que en lo que resta de vida podamos seguir contribuyendo a través de la academia con la educación, básicamente la educación superior en la República Dominicana. Y muchas gracias a todos. Muchas felicidades por el Día de nuestra Independencia Nacional.
Un ser humano buenísimo.
La mejor educador.
Tiene por convicción que orientar a las personas constituye una materia de enseñanza a cualquier persona, a cualquier estudiante. Y hoy las instituciones de aquí se sienten honradas con reconocer a un mocano tamborileño que está con nosotros, reconociendo sus dotes, reconociendo su personalidad, reconociendo su humanismo, reconociendo que personas como él tienen que crecer, duplicarse para bienestar de la sociedad. Llamamos con un fuerte aplauso al profesor Domingo Cava Ramos.
So now this is the time that we're gonna honor Domingo Cava Ramos. So we're gonna start with Quisqueya Sport Club.
Okay, yo quiero llamar a una persona para que entregue esto formalmente. Él es presidente Orlando Núñez, favor de pasar por aquí, ya que son tan amigos desde hace muchos años. Y yo quiero, sí, yo quiero de verdad.
No era pendiente, hermano.
Él se llena de orgullo, cariño, cariño, el entregar esto.
Buenas tardes para todos. En este día tan bonito que el Señor nos ha regalado, por lo menos la temperatura está agradable, no está tan fría como en otros años. Para mí fue un placer inmenso el toparme con mi amigo Cava en el Quisqueya Sport Club, antes de anoche. Me sentí bien de verdad. Porque es una persona grata, una persona humilde, un ser humano que cuando trabajamos juntos en Moca me ayudó a poder controlar un poquito de ira que yo tenía, era medio fogoso y eso. Me daba unos consejos que hasta el día de hoy me han servido para mucho. Cava, Que Papá Dios te siga bendiciendo y me dio gusto poder estar aquí contigo. Ahora le voy a leer este memo que dice así. Quiqueya Poclo, perdón, reconoce al licenciado Domingo Cava Ramos, maestro educador por excelencia, formidable ejemplo de familia, trabajador, colaborador permanente a favor de su pueblo, un ser humano especial y un gran hombre de servicio, quien vive para servir y hacer posible que cada día sea un mejor amanecer para todos sus semejantes. Dios te bendiga siempre. Dado en la villa de Havestro, New York, a los 27 días del mes de febrero del año 2022, en cumplimiento del 178 aniversario de nuestra independencia dominicana, por la directiva Roberto Germosén, presidente, Fernando Peña, vicepresidente, Alison Pichardo, tesorero, y Ale Rodríguez, secretario. Hermano.
Now this is the time for the town of Havestro, Howard Phillips, to do the honor for Domingo Cava.
I'm actually going to ask our councilman, Johnny Ortiz, to present this to you, Domingo. But thank you for being such a community leader within our community. Johnny.
Qué placer es reconocer a profesor Domingo Cava. Sabemos que usted vino desde la República Dominicana. Gracias por aceptar nuestra invitación. Y queremos que todos sepan que el profesor Domingo Cava también es un profesor de universidad. Domingo Cava es el college professor en la Dominican Republic. Y la verdad que para nosotros es un placer inmenso. Y el town de Havestro se distingue por su gran trabajo que usted realiza como profesor, como formador, como hablábamos anoche, que el profesor viene siendo como los padres de uno. Y nosotros, el town de Havestro, en apreciación por ese trabajo que usted hace, queremos reconocerlo en el día de hoy que celebramos el 178 aniversario de nuestra independencia dominicana. Por el town de Havestro, Howard Phillips y los concejales, es un honor para nosotros reconocerlo por su gran trabajo. También el asambleísta Ken Zembrowski quiere reconocerlo también. So now the time I'm going to bring Mike over here and Sabrina that you can come over.
On behalf of Rockland County Executive Ed Day, congratulations.
Esto es de parte de la legislatura del condado. Gracias por ser el líder que usted es y gracias por todo que hace por la comunidad.
All right, this is
on behalf of Senator Skoufis, congratulations. Congratulations.
Robert D'Amelio from West Havestro.
John, I just wanted to bring up my board for a second with me and
Rick Pakola. Congratulations, many accomplishments. So I have one question. I know you're an avid baseball fan, right? That's what I read about you? No?
Le aplaudimos todo lo que ha hecho para su gente y para todo lo que están aquí. Felicidades.
My God.
Domingo, congratulations on behalf of the village. Here's a certificate of appreciation for all that you've done and for the respect that you clearly engender in the community.
Sabrina, you done?
Okay.
So now this is the time for Domingo Cava to say a few words. So Domingo Cava, take the floor.
Trataré de hacer el cambio. Muchísimas gracias. Muchas gracias a todas las instituciones que han incidido o tomado parte en este reconocimiento. Muchísimas gracias a las personalidades que me han honrado con cada una de estas distinciones. Realmente, entre esas instituciones está este club que representa la comunidad latina y muy especialmente el municipio de Tamboril. En Tamboril yo he tenido el honor, he tenido el privilegio, y ahora que se habla en términos beisbolísticos, de batear para el ciclo. Porque en el pasado fui reconocido por el Club Rotario Tamboril. En una oportunidad fui reconocido por el Ayuntamiento de Tamboril. Fui reconocido por el Centro Comunal Tamboril y ahora me honro al recibir esta distinción, lo que parecería entonces que yo estoy bateando para el ciclo, pero contrario a lo que es el argot beisbolístico de que se juega para el ciclo, cuando se conecta en un juego hit, doble, triple y jonrón, yo creo que todo lo que yo he conectado es triple y jonrón. Porque el municipio de Tamboril en su momento me declaró a través de una resolución hijo adoptivo de dicho municipio, lo que significa que eso constituye un jonrón. Y cada uno de los reconocimientos posteriores han sido triples, de manera que yo creo que yo necesito o me merezco un rinconcito también, igual que el Big Papi en el Salón de la Fama. Ya hablando en términos tal vez menos humorísticos, los reconocimientos siempre he considerado que alegran, prestigian y satisfacen, pero al mismo tiempo comprometen. Y cuando digo que comprometen es porque genera un compromiso con distintas instancias. Primero con las instituciones y personalidades que lo otorgan. Segundo, con la comunidad de la que procede el reconocido. Tercero, con los hijos, con los padres, con la comunidad, con el país en general. Esto se compromete a una conducta rectilínea. ¿Qué pensarían los distinguidos miembros, personalidades e instituciones que me han honrado en esta fría tarde de invierno si yo cometo un acto que me hace indigno de haber recibido este reconocimiento? se arrepentirían para toda la vida. De manera que yo les aseguro desde hoy que no se van a arrepentir. Trataré por todos los medios de seguir el mismo camino hasta ahora recorrido, porque tal vez para eso me formaron. Me formó mi madre, con la que tuve que lidiar toda la vida, ya que mi padre murió 3 meses antes de yo nacer. De manera que a ella va dedicada estos reconocimientos, porque tal vez si ella no traza la ruta que yo debí seguir y cada uno de sus hijos, yo no estuviera aquí. Mis hermanos mayores, que siguieron la misma ruta, iluminaron el camino, a ellos va dedicado estas distinciones. A mi hija Nicole María, a quien entonces le digo que debe trazar el mismo camino de su padre. Pero le fallaría, y este reconocimiento tiene un significado agregado, es que me lo están otorgando el día de la independencia de la República Dominicana. Un significado especial, lo que significa que si yo fallo, además de fallarle a todas las instituciones, a mi país, le fallaría nada más y a nada menos que al padre de la nacionalidad dominicana, que es Juan Pablo Duarte. Y a Duarte no se le puede fallar. Muchísimas gracias.
Excelente palabra del profesor Domingo Cava. Now that we have Jehu over here, I think this is the time to make a sancocho, a heavy soup over here. We're going to bring all the honorees that we have over here, because in my bag, that complaint is getting cold. So we're going to bring over here Reverend Osvaldo Hernandez from St. Peter's Church. Lydia Paulino. Yarisa Lopez. Y Vanessa Martinez, if you can come over, please. So we're going to start with Padre Osvaldo Hernandez, and we're going to start with Quisqueya Sport Club.
Buenas tardes. El Quisqueya Sport Club se orgullece en dar este reconocimiento, Fernando Peña, a sus manos para el Padre Osvaldo Hernández.
Sí, buenas tardes a todos. Padre, un placer de verdad, nada más no verlo en la iglesia, sino también aquí, oyendo su consejo como siempre. Dice así, el Quisqueya Sport Club reconoce al Padre Osvaldo Hernández. Dios bendice tu gran obra, gracias por tu importante y significativa entrega en favor de lo nuestro. Nuestra institución apoya y valora en toda su dimensión tu gesto de bondad y solidaridad mostrada por usted ahora y por siempre. Gracias por ser parte de nuestra comunidad y nuestra institución social y cultural. Dado en la Villa de Javestro, hoy 27 de febrero del 2022, por su directiva, Roberto Germosén, presidente, un servidor, vicepresidente, Alex Pichardo, tesorero, Alex Rodríguez, secretario. Muchas felicidades, mi querido padre. Muy contento de haberle entregado.
We're going to call Howard Phillips.
Father, it's a pleasure to be here with you. Ladies, come on up here, Johnny. You know, we have so few good shepherds. It's so important, and I want to thank the Quisqueya Club for recognizing Father here today, because without those wonderful good shepherds, the priests, we would be a lost flock. So may God continue to look after you, provide for you, shine his light upon you. May his blessed mother always follow you wherever your ministry takes you. Thank you so much, Father. Congratulations. Thank you, Father.
Now this is the time for...
Reverend, on behalf of the County Executive Ed Day, I'd like to present you with the water recognition. Thank you so much. Congratulations. Thank you.
This one, this is from our New York State Assembly, Ken Zembrowski. I'm going to call West Abbotsford, Robert D'Amelio.
Thank you. Father, thank you. Pleasure to meet you. Thank you for all that you've done. Lily?
Este certificado es para todo lo que te has hecho para la comunidad en Abbotsford.
Now this is the time for Mike Cohart.
Father, it's always good to see you in church and outside of church, and on behalf of the village, we just want to present you with this certificate of our appreciation for all that you do for the people of Havistraw. Thank you.
From Senator Jens Kofis.
Thank you again. Father, you know, before I give you this, I have to say, you know, the Senate district is a huge district. It's from Rockland County through Orange County all the way up to Ulster County. So I get a chance to go to a lot of different events, a lot of different ethnic events. And I have to tell you, there's something different about this event. You can feel the spirit and the pride here. And for that, you should all give yourselves a round of applause. Hey. Father, congratulations from Senator Skoufis and the New York State Senate. Thank you so
much. Now, Sabrina Greco and Jay Hood.
Thank you, Johnny. Oh, Father, we just have a token of our appreciation for everything you do for the community, the Dominican community, and the Havistraw community, and, of course, we're so glad to have you in service at St. Peter's.
Padre Osvaldo, la comunidad de Havistraw lo quiere tanto a usted. Una cosa de la bandera dominicana. Es la única bandera en todo el mundo que tiene una Biblia en el símbolo en el medio. Y es bien un orgullo poder reconocerlo a usted hoy, porque Dios, patria y libertad.
Amén.
Amén.
Padre, ¿quieres decir a few words?
Okay. I wouldn't give a homily because I will stay here forever, but I would like to say thank you to all of you, also for all the great job that you do in the community here in Havistraw. For me, when I was assigned here, I was like, oh my goodness, I'm going to Gringolandia. So that's not going to be a lot of Hispanic over there. So I get to Havistraw, to St. Peter, and I am surrounded by old Platano power people. So it's been a great 4 years now in the community, knowing everyone. 2018, and it was like since like yesterday. And I have to say, I would like to thank each one of you for all the great things that you do for the community, especially in St. Peter, the town, the village, each one of you, how you support our mission, not only the mission of the church, but the mission of the universal church as Christian, no matter what religion we're from. I think the town of Havistraw show that we're there for everybody. And that's what makes it unique. And that's what we need to do as Christian and as a Catholic. We ought to be one as a body of Christ, but we also need to remember that there's other that they share with faith and they don't share with faith, but we all one in Jesus. And that's what's matter right now. So thank you for all you did during the pandemic. It was amazing how the village came together. Thank you for supporting us. Thank you for supporting the church. And God bless America and bless the Dominican Republic and bless each one of you. Thank you.
Dominicano hasta la tambora.